So obviously we don't want a show where everyone just looks like hardcore Holly and Chris Benoit clones as we'd all fall asleep. It's not just the wrestlers' getup though, but the way they look performing in the ring is important too. From the coolest characters to the most deranged, here are the most entertaining WWE wrestlers to look at, starting with Aleister Black.
I'm well in this matchup against Aleister Black.
Now known as Malakai Black in AEW, this might be the single biggest missed opportunity in the last 5 years. How could they not find a consistent push for this man? He had authenticity, both in how he looked as a heavy metal devil worshiper and in how he performed with the added element of Dutch Muay Thai and athleticism. He even cut a cool, spooky promo. What was it, Vince? Why did you let this guy go? Why?
Aleister Black!
Aleister Black!
Kane. There have been many different versions of the Big Red Machine over the years, but we're just going to focus on two of them. The original Kane we saw back in the late 90s with the full mask and the single arm exposed is easily his greatest look. He looked straight out of an 80s horror movie, and his mannerisms matched perfectly. This version of Kane got a world title run off a prime Stone Cold Steve Austin for one day. This version legitimately scared kids, unlike the goofy, mouth-exposed mask of 2002. The other great look Kane had was when he first unmasked in 2003, being led to the ring in chains and surrounded by guards. He was terrifying to look at, and he had the in-ring skills to back it up. Look at this chokeslam. Asuka. The Empress of Tomorrow always had an interesting look to her, but when she debuted the full face paint in WWE, she took it to another level. That one addition was enough to completely revamp her character, sending her barreling forward to another world title run. Asuka's entrance is always a spectacle, but I would argue that the music she had when she first arrived to the main roster was better than the current one.
Going at it here.
Right for the discus. Cross. Yes.
Oh, Asuka forward. Asuka, oh, Asuka, Asuka,
Mankind. The bizarre leather mask, the patches of missing hair from tearing it out himself, even the mandible claw was so unnerving that it didn't matter that there was no high impact involved. Everything Mankind did, from launching himself out of the ring to twitching weirdly on his way to the ring, was creepy as hell. Not to mention he's been a part of so many brutal, hardcore moments in WWE history, we can't keep count, but here's a few.
On the other side, there's...
The Ministry of Darkness. Way before I started watching wrestling, I was aware of The Undertaker. He stood out on posters, and his dark demeanor captivated me way before I was a fan. When he went full evil in 1999 with the Ministry of Darkness, you just couldn't take your eyes away from the group. Legitimate tough guys, the Acolytes, vampires from the Brood, the ghastly pallbearer, the horrifying Viscera, and that useless tit Midian. There was always something to look at in this group. From holding satanic sermons to kidnapping other wrestlers and crucifying them, there was always, always something to look at when this group was on the screen.
Where to, Stephanie?
Fights! That's 500 pounds of Viscera!
The Wyatt.
We're here.
Every version of this group was entertaining and believable. Everything they did looked authentic, and listening to the late, great Bray Wyatt speak sounded like he'd been preparing for the role his entire life.
Wake up and look at this line I'm living in, man!
Harper and Rowan did not look like typical WWE wrestlers, especially in 2013, giving Wyatt legitimacy in his cult-like group. Later, when the monstrous black sheep Braun Strowman was added, we got the first all-Big Hoss faction that I can remember in the WWE. Wyatt altered his look later on, adding some dreadlocks and looking straight out of a Rob Zombie concert, but he always pulled it off perfectly. Rest in peace, you unbelievably amazing talent. CM Punk. When CM Punk debuted on WWE TV in 2006, no one had tattoos like him. This was 3 years removed from Randy Orton getting his full sleeve tattoos, and the only other person was the undead Undertaker. But CM Punk felt fresh, authentic, and like one of the guys diehard fans could really get behind. You could tell Vince didn't want him to win, at least not at first, and that made him so much cooler in the fans' eyes. He was great on the mic too. Let's never forget when he completely buried Shannon Moore by calling him a poser and then slapping him.
I have the balls to say things that nobody else has the balls to say.
Oh, sleep connects! Jericho, he's got to tap out!
The APA.
Comes out, half the men they went in.
Oh!
The Accolade Protection Agency were the epitome of cool in the early 2000s. Two legitimately tough alpha males that would hang out backstage playing poker, drinking beer, and smoking cigars. Any wrestler could show up and pay them to beat up another wrestler or to at least protect them from another wrestler's attack. And when it came time to fight, man, did these two hit hard. Bradshaw is notorious for stiff shots, but Farouk was no slouch with his spinebuster and dominator as well. Find me a move more enjoyable to watch than a stiff early 2000s clothesline from hell.
Days away from Survivor Series.
On Triple H. And now, look out! A double team.
Let's be honest about it.
It's total tough combo.
Brock Lesnar.
6-3-53!
There's a reason Brock Lesnar draws money everywhere he goes. To paraphrase Joe Rogan, he looks like the result of Vikings breeding with each other over the course of generations. It's not just the massive muscles, many tattoos, or block-shaped head either. Every move Brock does, from simple suplexes to his finisher, the F5, look absolutely deadly. In the early 2000s, the way Brock could move was insane. Look at him take this chokeslam from The Undertaker. Look at him lift the 400-pound Mark Henry like it's nothing. Even now with his bizarre ponytail and beard, you can't argue that there's always a reason to shine the spotlight on Brock.
Oh no! Touch the leg! The streak is over!
Team Extreme. The Hardy Boys and Lita captivated us as soon as they came on the TV screen. Both Hardys with their alternative attire, Lita with her punk rock sex appeal, and Jeff Hardy later with his face paint and body paint. They could absolutely back it up in the ring too, with Matt's twist of fate and Jeff's swanton bomb becoming staples in the cool finisher community. Not to mention the endless hardcore spots all three were part of. Check out Lita hit Spike Dudley with this chair, Matt Hardy falling off a ladder through tables, and Jeff Hardy delivering the whisper in the wind off the top of a cage.
Wait, 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 wait! Wait a minute now! Oh, good. This'll do it. He won't do the top of the ladder!
The Bloodline. There's nothing like a big group in wrestling that all share a similar look. We talked about the Wyatt family earlier, but check out the Bloodline with their red and black attire, matching tattoos, and distinct hairstyles. When the Bloodline was at its peak, you had three legitimate brothers and a cousin in the group, so the additions of Paul Heyman and Sami Zayn weren't enough to throw off the visual dynamic. From the entrance itself to the way Roman Reigns captivated fans with his presence, the look of the group drew you in immediately. Plus, most of the men involved in the group have been a part of some classic matches and moments.
Man, I don't give a damn what the Tribal Chiefs say!
Finn Balor, the Demon.
Here comes Finn Balor!
Finn Balor killed it as the Demon. The long entrance, complete with badass music and an ominous crawl to the ring, set the tone for the spectacle that was to come. This more aggressive version of Balor gave us high-impact moves and more drama in the match, as this version of him rarely lost. It's a shame that this version of Finn only held the world title for 24 hours and reminds me heavily of Kane's 1998 single-day reign. Man, he had some great matches like this, though. That concludes our list of the most entertaining WWE wrestlers to look at. Who did we forget? Let us know in the comments below.